And this morning, there are positive signs for how the United States is navigating the pandemic. For the first time, more Americans have been fully vaccinated against coronavirus than have been infected by it. It was exactly 1 year ago today that Dr. Sanjay Gupta told us right here on New Day that the U.S. was entering a new and very dangerous phase. CNN is now calling the outbreak a global pandemic. Our senior medical correspondent, Dr. Sanjay Gupta, joins us to explain why. What makes it a pandemic, Sanjay?
Well, I mean, there are criteria that are somewhat defined to call something a pandemic. And let me just preface by saying, you know, this terminology that we're going to start using now isn't so much to cause panic, but rather to really cause a focus on preparedness.
Can you believe how close we were sitting to each other?
That was a striking thing. We were right next to each other. I can't imagine being that close to a non-family member.
What were we thinking? On that day, just 22 Americans had died from the virus. A year later, that number is 525,000 Americans.
This morning, the CDC is releasing guidance for what is safe to do after being fully vaccinated. Yes, go hug your grandchildren, but still concerns about travel. The CDC director warns the next 8 weeks will be crucial for the direction of the pandemic and preventing another surge. Joining us now, you heard from a moment ago, CNN chief medical correspondent Dr. Sanjay Gupta. Most remarkable how close Allison and I were sitting 1 year ago and how you haven't aged a minute.
How dare you?
Since 1 year ago, despite
I'm not still just
sleeping,
as far away.
Not sleeping a minute over the last year. It's, you know, I don't like to do it too often, but to think about what we've been through the last year, to think about what you were saying then, you didn't want to cause a panic. On the other hand, what came to pass was certainly worthy, I think, of being majorly concerned.
Yeah, no, I think that's exactly right. I mean, you know, that was a Monday, you know, March 9th last year. And I remember being up all weekend that weekend writing this article, thinking about it, looking at the data. And, you know, it was heady stuff because remember, the CDC had not declared this a pandemic. The World Health Organization had not declared this a pandemic. The president was still saying this is just, it's going to go away just, you know, a few days. So to go out there and say it was a pandemic, you know, it was a different phase, as you mentioned. But it was correct because that's what the data showed. But I got to tell you, honestly, you know, at that point, it was still very much a prepare for the worst, but hope for the best sort of feel. The idea that it could have gone from 22 people who had died at that point to 525,000, like you see on the screen. There's no way I could have, I think anybody, frankly, if they're being honest, could have anticipated that, even in sort of the worst case scenarios. So it felt like it was a different phase, and the phase was of preparedness, but then all the actions, at least the immediate actions after that, really weren't following, and that was sort of the great tragedy of all this.
Sanjay, I just want to read what you wrote back then, because it was so prescient. Back then, exactly 1 year ago today, you wrote, now is the time to prepare for what may be ahead. That could mean quarantines, closed schools, and canceled events in your town. It might mean strain at work or taking a break from hobbies that usually bring you joy. It might mean putting off a family vacation or catching up over the phone instead of getting together. I mean, that you predicted it all. It was all right there. You didn't say Zoom meetings, but you might as well have. And it sounded like you were just, you know, really out there at the time, and all of that came to pass.
Yeah, I mean, you know, and there were people who, you know, in the infectious disease community who were sort of raising the alarm on this for some time, but there was such dissonance. You remember, guys, because you know, going to the White House, talking to the president, interviewing other people, and they're saying, do not make a big deal about this. This is going to go away. You know, all it's going to do is cause panic. And on the other hand, again, you know, I think one thing that we've tried to really always do here, especially at this network, is lean into the evidence, the data, the facts, you know, in terms of what we were seeing. And the thing about pandemics, the thing about lots of illnesses is that you don't always see it before it strikes you. By the time it actually starts manifesting, you're late. So you have to sort of, you know, be predictive of these things ahead of time. But the people are going outside, as many people have said on your program, and looking outside and saying, hey, sky's clear. Things look great. What are you talking about? And that's always a tough position to be in as a doctor, as a reporter, whatever, to say, yeah, it looks good right now, but you've got to take warning here and be careful. So here we are, 1 year later to the day.
All right, that's the rearview mirror. Let's look forward. Now, we have this new CDC guidance for what they think is safe to do, and that's been chewed over for 24 hours. And you've got new reporting, Sanjay, from Andy Slavitt at the White House, who in some ways is, you know, help run the vaccinations, getting shots in people's arms. What are you hearing about what we can expect?
What we're hearing is there's no question that they're being cautious. I mean, you've heard that over and over again. I heard Peter Hotez talking about it last hour. They are being cautious. A lot of people are coming on saying, hey, they're being overly cautious. You know, why can't vaccinated people do more? But Andy Slavitt and others will say, yeah, we are purposely under-promising, hoping to over-deliver. But there was two other things that I think were really important. One is that you don't hear things as binary as you used to. Can't do this, can do this. You're going to start hearing things more framed as low risk, medium risk, high risk, giving people a little bit more choice. Second thing is that the recommendations that we hear are going to be directly tied to the percent of the country that is vaccinated. So 10% roughly of the country fully vaccinated right now, 2 million, roughly 2.5 million people per day will be vaccinated. So you'll get to 20% of the country within the next couple of weeks, 30% by the end of March. My point is that each time that happens, you're probably going to hear a loosening of the recommendations coming from the CDC. And by the way, the recommendations, again, and Andy Slavitt made this point, from the CDC. Those were CDC recommendations. Those weren't CDC recommendations where HHS or the White House then, you know, changed the recommendations or dropped things onto the CDC's website. So that's it. But I think they're being cautious right now because of, you know, how this last year has transpired.
Sanjay, how about travel? Why are they being so cautious about travel? Haven't airlines made all sorts of safety provisions that have changed, that have made airline travel safer over the past year?
Yeah, no, I think that one's going to change. And I think that one will change. That recommendation will be loosened, you know, within the next couple of weeks. We have not seen large outbreaks on airline travel. Over the last 4 days, 4.5 million people traveled. We've been tracking airline travel for a year now, saying, look, okay, so people have still been traveling. Have there been distinct outbreaks linked to that? We really haven't seen that. There have been a few isolated sort of cases of transfer on planes over the last year. But this gets back to the caution thing. If you look at the guidelines specifically, they're basically saying, hey, look, if you're vaccinated, you're pretty good to go. You're not going to get sick, and you're very likely to transmit the virus. If you go into a household where people are young and not having some pre-existing illness, it's unlikely to be a medium or high-risk situation. That's a low-risk situation. On an airplane, they're basically saying, look, could there be somebody on the plane who is vulnerable, not yet vaccinated, and at increased risk? Despite the fact you're wearing masks and you have good ventilation, they still want to be cautious here. I think that's going to change by reading the tea leaves and talking to lots of people, and I think that'll happen in the next couple of weeks.
We're watching. And also, there's a difference between shouldn't and can't. It's not like they're CDC police grabbing you by the collar and dragging you off planes. They're just saying that we are not yet sanctioning this as something that we think is completely safe yet. Sanjay, thank you. Fascinating to take a look back, and we'll talk to you again a little bit later.
Okay. Yeah.